Welcome to the kitchen sink. Now please welcome your hosts, Andy Radke and Brett Johnson.
Hello everybody, how you doing? Welcome to the kitchen sink. I'm Andy.
I'm Brett.
And I want to thank you very much for joining us for episode number 7.
Number 7,
lucky
yep.
Number 7.
Yeah, and thank you for all the views too.
Yeah, we're getting a lot more. We're getting more views now.
Yeah,
that's cool.
And
people are watching.
Some comments on it too.
Yeah, people are watching, which I really love.
It'd be nice if we got more than just Chris commenting on our videos, please.
Yeah, our buddy Chris, he comments with his brand of
sense of humor,
if you want to call it that.
Yeah.
But,
we love you, Chris.
Yeah. Well, I get excited when I see that we have a comment that I just realize it's just him with his smart-ass remarks.
Yeah, So, send them on Facebook.
Yeah. But anyway, yeah, it's March 24th, and we only have 1 week away until April. And
I'm still surprised we're on 7. Like you said, 7th episode.
Yeah.
Lucky 7.
Lucky number 7, yeah.
And like you said, we're a week away from
Easter.
Easter.
Easter's next week.
I'm a month away from another year older.
Yeah, you turn older.
Something.
Next week? Yeah. Next month?
No, I'm 52. I'm not.
You're not one of those people that worried about your age.
No,
right?
I'm not 52. I'm 18 with 34 years of experience.
Ah, there you go.
I'm perpetual. I'm a Toys R Us kid.
But if you watched last week, like I said, we've been trying to improve the presentation of the podcast.
Yes.
With the whole chroma key effect, the green screen stuff, and made
just
some improvements
for those bull horns. Okay,
yeah. We made some improvements, and as there were only two issues last week left.
Only two?
I think so.
I thought there was only one.
Oh no, there are two.
Okay,
I promise you there are two. I'm about to tell you what they are.
Okay.
Because, like I said, I moved the microphone out of the way, so that was fine. I took the hat off, took the headphones off and all that, so that was all cleared up last week.
Yeah.
But there are only two issues left. The first was the back of my chair.
Yeah.
I was using my computer chair, and if you watched last week's episode, you could see the back of it glitching big time,
mm-hmm.
Going transparent and this and that, so... I fixed that. I decided to use my kitchen chair instead. My computer chair is over here.
Well, I thought you wanted to just do the image of the illusion that you were floating in space.
Yeah. Jeez.
Okay, yeah.
But there's one other issue that needed to be fixed.
Okay.
Your fucking hair.
My hair?
Your hair. Have you seen your hair on the podcast?
Oh, yes.
Your hair glitzes something fierce. That cap cut does not like your hair.
No.
I don't know why.
I don't kind of... Don't have much of it.
Well, you got enough.
Yeah.
And there's a solution to this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I found a solution.
An Indian? Oh, no.
Yes. For the sake of the podcast...
Okay.
We must shave you bald.
Okay.
All right? Okay. You ready for this? All right. But,
Oh, I did. I lost.
You did. You got the...
Santa Claus is gone.
Yeah, Santa Claus disappeared.
Yeah, well, he'll be back in December. Yeah.
Brett Johnson's my co-host now. Santa Claus is no longer on the show.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, we went to the Mudmen concert last night, as we told you.
Yes.
And my God, what a show.
Oh.
This was the first concert I'd been to in 5 years. 6 for him.
6 for me, yep.
And I tell you right now, my friends, there is nothing better than live music therapy to soothe your soul.
Yes, and especially if you're sitting in the second row center.
We had second row center seats at the River Run
Best
Center.
Best seats.
Great seats.
Yes, I thought so.
And
I
totally forgot how comfortable those seats
are. They were comfortable.
Because I've been to the
I
River
Run. I wish we had those seats right now.
Yeah. Oh, no. Well, my computer chair was comfortable, but I sacrificed for the sake of the podcast.
Yeah, I know.
Are you willing to?
Yes.
This was such a great show.
Like
I mentioned previously, they're a Celtic rock band hailing from Ontario.
Yep.
A ton of accolades. Like, they've played for the Queen. They've been. They've had their music on the show Shameless. The WWE, one of the tag teams.
The Highlanders tag team.
Yeah, they use their music as theme music.
Yeah, the Hockey Night in Canada theme.
Yeah, they did the Hockey Night in Canada theme at one point.
They've done numerous Walk of Fame ceremonies.
Oh, yeah.
They're
fantastic.
Oh, yeah. They've been around for 26 years.
Yeah. So. And since you got the tickets back in September, we decided to become well-versed in their music. We listened to a lot of their music over the last 6-7 months.
Yep.
And so going into the concert, we pretty much knew almost every song that they played, except for the unreleased stuff, which will be on their...
You only had one gripe.
One gripe only. I had one tiny gripe.
Same gripe he has with Honeymoon Suite.
Yeah. Well, what drew me to the Mudmen originally last year, when I first saw them like online,
yeah,
was when they performed their cover of AC/DC's It's a Long Way to the Top if You Want to Rock and Roll.
Yes.
And I hoped and prayed that they would perform that last night.
They have a new singer now.
Yeah. See, the singer that recorded that with them is no longer with them. The singer they have now has been with them for, what, 3 years, they said?
Yeah, he said 3 years, yeah. Yes.
And he's more of a country singer. He's more of a country tone to his voice than, say, hard rock.
Well, yeah, they said he's had an independent career.
He's still won Juno Awards and stuff like that.
And they said he's still got play on the...
He's had airplay on the radio, I guess.
And he still gets it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
and that's the one thing about Mudmen. They said they don't get radio play.
No.
But they are a phenomenal band. If you ever get a chance to see them.
If you want some really good, feel-good music, you know, and...
The
two guys, the two brothers, the Campbell brothers, right?
That's Sandy and Rob.
Yeah. You'll see I'm going to post a picture right here for
you. Yeah, we met them.
We met them after the show. I had a photo op.
The only person that's not in that photo is their bassist. He was talking to some people.
We got 5 out of 6. Yeah,
5 out of 6, like I did for autographs. But
as I was saying...
You were saying about the brothers.
Yeah. You got these two guys on each side of the stage with these bagpipes, and they play...
Oh, yeah.
And they play in perfect unison.
Oh, yes.
And it is just...
Oh, they are great.
Pardon the pun, great music to the ears.
Yeah, they are. They are. It is.
It's phenomenal.
You wouldn't think rock and roll and bagpipes, except for the one AC/DC song. That's the only time I've ever heard rock and roll music with bagpipes.
Yeah.
They make it work.
Yeah. Well, their lead guitarist was insane, too.
Oh, yes.
You should see this guy.
And he plays banjo as well.
Like there's nobody's business.
They're an Ontario band. Like the guitarist and their bassist live in Kitchener.
Kitchener, yeah.
Rob, I believe he said, lives in London.
Right.
He was telling us. Well, the lead singer said at one time he lived for 6 months in Bushland.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So they're from around this area.
They play a lot of local...
just to say how well we're versed in it, like I just looked it up. They're coming to Fergus in November and Erin in October. We're going to try to go see them again in one of those two. And if you are out there and you want to check them out, like I said, Fergus and...
Erin. Yeah.
I'll look up the dates. You can maybe put it in the description for people so they can know.
But I'm a fan. I am a bona fide fan of these guys.
I put this above that Gowan concert that we saw. Oh, yeah. This is my favorite concert.
If you go see them and you don't leave smiling ear to ear, there's something wrong with you.
It is. It's a good time.
It was good.
Like you said, the show was...
It's a good 2-hour show with a 20-minute intermission after the first hour.
Yeah, they started at 8. They went till 9.
Yep.
They came back at 9:30. Then they finished.
They finished about 10:30 or so.
10:30. So yeah, and they had a meet and greet afterwards. Yep. And it was, you didn't have to pay for the meet and greet.
No.
It was great, and it was, and like you said, you're gonna put up the picture with them.
Yes, absolutely. And I got some swag.
Yeah,
I got some swag. There's my Mudmen shirt right here.
Mm-hmm.
I got that. See, Brett here's a little disgruntled, and I'm about to tell you why. When we got there, we went to the merch table. We got shirts.
Yep.
And that's fine and well. Brett drives, but we decided to take the bus downtown for the concert.
A lot easier.
Yeah, because parking can be a bitch and what have you.
I do live close to downtown, but we were not sure with the weather and the how the sidewalk.
It was cold. It was cold last night.
Yeah,
it was
so very cold. I don't mind parking here, and I bought the transit pass, the on the way card, so I had money on it. I only used it one time with you. So
anyway, we took the bus there and we took the bus back.
Mm-hmm.
So we got back to my place just before 11:30 last night. And Brett realized almost instantly after he got off the bus that he had left his shirt on the bus. So he was not a happy camper, and frankly, I don't blame him because, $25 for a souvenir shirt just to watch it ride away, in the sunset.
Yeah.
But I took it upon myself. He went home, and... And I told him, so I'm going to email Gulf Transit. Maybe somebody turned into the lost and found or whatever.
I didn't let it spoil my night, though. It's But there's no sense in doing that.
But what I did, like the last bus that comes by here is about just before 12:30 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided, because the route that comes by here, which is the 10, once it does the route from, you know, back downtown, it converts into the 12.
Yeah,
which is the general hospital. Which takes to the general hospital. And then after that route, it reverts back to the 10. So I knew after an hour it was going to be the exact same bus that we were on.
Yeah.
So I decided just before 12:30, I'm going to wait at the bus stop. When the bus comes up, I'm going to talk to the driver, see if anybody turned it in, because it was the same bus driver.
Yeah, that was good.
And he said, no, nothing, no one's turned anything in. So I said, well, it's okay if I, you know, I'll check the seats, like under the seats for a minute. He said, sure, go ahead. So nothing.
Yep.
So
we tried.
Yeah, so I'm willing to bet.
That's a good friend, though.
I try. I roll. That's how I roll.
Yeah, I know.
That's how I roll. But I put out Blurb and Cotton Guelph just on the long shot that I might turn out. Because, you know, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take.
Yep. Like Gretzky says.
Yeah. Wise man. Wise man.
Yep.
And like I said, I reported it to Guelph Transit. So maybe, I don't know.
Yeah.
But worst case scenario, you know, his birthday is next month. I am going to buy him the shirt that he lost.
Oh, thank you. That's good.
You're not going to be without your shirt.
Yeah, I know.
But in the meantime, I would, if you don't mind, I'd like to take a moment to pay our respects to your fallen shirt that we had lost. Thank you.
In the arms of the angel, fly away from here, from this star.
I'm gonna go on that. I didn't get I was upset I lost it, but okay, I've lost worse mounts. I had,
well, like I said, at least it wasn't your wallet or
My wallet,
something significant.
And like I said before, I've had somebody take $200 on me, so that's you know, $25, it was, but I just, it's an extra it was an extra price just to see the show. And was phenomenal, so it not bad. Well, like, if it hadn't been a bad show, I might have been upset to spend that, but no.
Well, that's what I said before you left. I said, don't let it overshadow the fact that you had a good night.
And I just said, the next time I'm going, I'm taking a bag with me.
Yeah, something, yeah.
Yeah, I'll take.
But anyway, we went to see the Ghostbusters movie this afternoon.
Yep.
As we told you we were going to do. And the original.
But we were going to go see it at night.
Yeah, the original plan was to go see it in the evening.
Yep.
And in which case, I wasn't going to bring it up during this episode.
Yep.
Because you were almost going to. Because I saw it Thursday with our buddy Chris.
Yep.
And so we went and saw that. You liked it.
Yeah, I loved it. I agree with you about the, in parts it was slow paced.
Yeah, I feel the pacing could have been a lot better with that movie. I think they saved pretty much all the flash and dash for the end of it.
Yep.
Without giving too much away.
Yeah, yeah. And
there was way too much slow paced dialogue I think they could have cut back on.
But like I said, it did look in the credits like that it was wrote by both Jason and Ivan Reitman. And it might have been that the script wasn't fully finished, or that when his dad passed.
Yeah, it could have been like a paradigm shift between
them. Yeah, he was trying to mesh the two things together
But I liked Afterlife far more, if I'm being honest.
Yeah.
I thought Afterlife was phenomenal.
But it was a good thing he did see it, because he fell asleep in the theater because he hasn't had much.
Well, this is how I am usually after a concert. I am full of piss and vinegar, wired for sound.
Yeah, I
have such a hard time coming down from that.
Oh, I know. I had the same thing.
And not from lack of trying. Like, I laid there and I tossed and turned, and you know, it's like, fuck, go to sleep. Like, Jesus, brain, shut off. Except, you know. And it's terrible. So I didn't get to sleep till about 4 o'clock this morning.
And I fell asleep at 3:30.
Yeah. So, and I was up at 7:30. So
I was up at 7. So we were up.
So you've had very little sleep too.
Yeah, but still.
But the fact that I had already seen the movie, I thought, okay, I'm not missing a whole lot. I can close my eyes.
The only thing I had to talk to him, asked him if he was all right, because he was snoring.
Oh, was I snoring?
Yes, you were.
Oh my God.
Not that loud, but I could hear you.
Oh shit.
That's why when I asked you, are you okay? And you're like, oh, yeah, I'm okay.
Oh, that's not good. I know I kept doing the whole head bobbing.
You know, but you snored that one time, and I was like, okay, are you okay?
I was zonked. But like I said, I just watched it like 3 days ago.
Yeah, yeah. So it's not that bad.
But
which I found, I mentioned to you, that's kind of weird because you saw it on the 21st, mm-hmm. and some of the advertisements said it wasn't out until the 22nd. Yeah. So it was
a lot of theaters were like a preview, like a day before.
So that might have been also why you said there was not a lot of people in there on the 21st. Maybe a lot of people were thinking it came out on Friday.
Yeah, because when we went on the Thursday night, we caught the 9:15 show, and there were literally only four people in the theater: myself, Chris, and another and this couple.
Yeah,
and that was it. I thought, holy shit! But yeah, that could be.
They were probably mad that you guys were there because they were probably wanting to make out.
You never know.
You never know.
Cut a hole in the bottom of the popcorn bag and
yeah, baby.
You know, you're watching too many porn movies. Oh, chicka bow bow. Jeez. Well, yeah, it was a good. It was a good movie.
Yeah, I liked it.
I'm sure they're going to do another one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sure they will. Well, it's a huge franchise.
And like and this isn't giving anything away because it says it's a Ghost Corp film, and that's Jason Reitman's thing. So if he's going to call it Ghost Corp, I'm sure he's going to be doing more ghost-type movies.
Well, Ghost Corp was responsible for Afterlife, too.
Oh, now, speaking of ghosts.
Yeah. I actually broke my own rule. I wasn't going to do this. But I decided to break down and watch the Beetlejuice trailer, the new one, because the teaser trailer dropped this week.
Yeah, because we got to have content to talk about.
We got to talk about things.
Yeah.
But my original plan was to avoid the trailer so I could go into the movie this September not knowing anything, not seeing anything.
Teaser trailer leaves a lot of more questions.
The teaser did not reveal a whole lot. You basically saw the town.
Yeah.
The town from the first one.
The main characters. Yeah,
the bridge where the Maitlands died.
Yeah.
And
Catherine O'Hara's character, Winona Ryder's character, and
Jenna Ortega.
Jenna Ortega.
Wednesday Addams, for those who watch Wednesday.
Yeah. And Beetlejuice.
Yeah.
That's him, but all you really see.
But I mean, you see the model of the town in the attic.
Yeah.
And all that. And, but no, it's just a lot of little nods to the original.
Yeah, it's just nothing.
Yet this vocal rendition of Deo.
Yeah, yeah.
The Banana Boat song from Harry Belafonte. So it's kind of, they incorporated that into it.
Actually, I do want to, speaking about Ghostbusters, and this isn't, it's not a spoiler, but they had a lot of nods to the original movies in that one.
Though. Oh, yeah.
Both the two.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
More
so
than they did in Afterlife.
Agreed.
That's the one I did like in that.
Agreed, yeah.
Yeah. But anyways, the
Easter eggs, as they call them.
Yeah, the Beetlejuice one was great. Well, yeah, actually, they had an Easter egg there, too, that wasn't in the movie, and I won't say it because it'll spoil it, but people will see what I mean.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
But I'm excited for Beetlejuice.
Oh yeah,
more so now than ever.
Oh yeah, I told you it would hype it up more.
Yeah.
Like I saw it and I'm like, I got more questions than.
Well, yeah, well, that's what a teaser does. Like, because I'm sure they're still in the middle of post production because it's not coming up for another 7 months or. Whatever,
yeah.
So it's still a ways to go, but
yeah,
it's nice that they give us a little treat, you know.
You know, I'd be. You know, it could be a little treat. I know somebody said that it's not there, but you never know. It'd be nice if they did have like even a post-credit scene with Gina Davis.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That would be kind of...
You never know.
You never know, yeah.
You never know. See, I was kind of hoping... actually, I'm not going to say it, again, I don't want to give anything away
or
allude to anything.
Yeah, we can't do that.
So I'm going to keep quiet about that. Yeah. But, your dad sent you something really cool in the mail.
Oh, yes.
This
was supposed to be for work, but I probably won't be using it for work. But he sent me this.
His father is amazingly skilled.
Oh, yeah.
Look at this.
See that? And then I'll turn it so it looks the other way. It looks like the wolf is still looking at you. It's great.
Okay, now explain to the folks what it is, because to them it might look like a medieval sex toy.
It's, you know? It's a paddle.
Okay, that's not helping much. Well, it's a panel.
It's supposed to be for
we're bad boy.
if I get a woman, no. Well, at work we use ping pong paddles, and they have signs on them,
right?
And the story is there's this one guy. There's a real. We had this one paddle. He takes it home with him because he's. He doesn't want it to get ruined.
Okay.
And I jokingly said to my dad, I would like you to make me one. Well, he made it a little bit bigger than a ping pong paddle. He said it's more like a badminton racket kind of size, but still, he made it for me. But I think it's too nice to put a a sign over the top
it
of
it. It is nice, yeah.
It's really nice. And he does really good work.
How long has he been doing stuff like that? Hey, that's
for years.
Crazy skilled, man.
I'll bring in next time. He made me a... I'm going to put this back over there. He made me... it's a clock with a dragon.
Oh, okay.
Like, I have a dragon with all the woodwork. Like, he makes a lot of stuff. Like, if anybody, you give us a shout out or that, or you want something made or that, I can check it out.
Oh, yeah.
He doesn't do it for cheap, like, for free, but...
Well, that's craftsmanship,
but yeah,
man.
Yeah, he's got his own little workshop that he built and that. He's got all the stuff. He loves doing that.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Keeps him... Like, he's supposed to be retired, but that's what he does now.
Well, nothing wrong with that at all.
He said most of the people that he knows, they retire when they don't do anything. They die.
Yeah.
So he's keeping himself.
Oh, yeah.
And he's,
gotta keep busy.
He'll be 80 this year.
Holy shit.
Yeah, so, and he's doing shit like that.
That's wild, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
That's very cool.
Yeah, it's very cool. And,
So, as I said last week, I performed at the Masquerade. I showed you some footage and whatnot.
Yeah.
And I'm already preparing for next year, believe it or not. I've been racking my brain trying to think of what song I can do next year that could top what I did this year, because I did the Blue Rodeo song this year.
Okay.
And I've knocked it down to three.
The Beatles Now and Then?
Yeah. No. Okay. No, but I knocked it down to three potential songs.
Rolling Stones Angry?
Nope.
Okay. Sorry, I'm just throwing songs at
me. Oh, yeah. You could.
Yeah, but I get it.
Yeah. Well, the first one I'm thinking of is Purple Rain by Prince.
Okay, I've never heard you sing that one.
No, not too many people have.
Okay.
About 20...
Is there a reason for that?
No, it's just a really cool song. Okay.
I mean a reason nobody's heard you sing it. You sing it
No.
I'm just teasing you.
No, but I think about 25 years ago was the last time I ever sang it in public.
Okay.
But it's just a really cool song.
Okay. What's your other ones?
The other ones, I was thinking of Elvis, If I Can Dream.
Okay, that's cool.
Another powerful song I really like. And the third one is Phil Collins, I Wish It Would Rain Down.
Cool. You know what we should do?
Yeah.
Getting close to it next year. Why don't we put a poll on here and let them say what would they like to see?
Well, okay. That's an idea.
Yeah.
I'm not letting them decide, though.
No.
If they pick something I really don't want to do, I'm not going
to
do it for the sake of...
Yeah, but I know. You narrow it down to what you really want to do. Like, if you got one or two, and then let them decide if you can't decide it.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm sorry you might hear that. Accidentally hit my mic there, but
that's fine. But yeah, I had so much fun doing that last year. I'm already thinking about next year.
Oh yeah, yet he said he was scared. He was nervous. I don't think he was.
Yeah. Oh, well, believe me, I was.
I don't know. I don't believe you.
Next time,
and yeah, he's actually going to wear ears and a tail. He said,
"I'm going to get into it." You know?
Yeah.
I'm gonna get,
I said, you should get some black paint on your eyes and make yourself a raccoon.
Oh, jeez. No.
I'm just kidding.
If I sleep as little as I have, but I won't need to put anything on my eyes. Jeez.
No.
But, it'll come naturally.
Yeah.
But I figured, they all dress up. I thought, I'll get the spirit of it.
That's a smart move.
It's like I said, I can't wear the full suit because I can't see where the shit in it. I can't afford a suit like that anyway. No. But,
my tail's in an ear you can afford.
But yeah. But, I'm enjoying hanging out with these people and whatnot.
Oh, yeah, yeah. They seem like very nice people.
A lot of them are Keith's friends and all that, and...
I want to meet some of them.
Yeah.
Some of this time.
Yeah. Well, like I said, go to the meet.
Well, maybe when we're getting Keith to come out camping with us, maybe he can convince one of his friends to come out and camp with us, too.
Yeah, no doubt. Yeah. But, so Easter is next week.
Yeah, Easter. You said, the weather's getting better. I hope it's not cold enough that the poor Easter bunny freezes his poor little eggs off.
I'm freezing my
Oh, jeez. Get his old... Easter egg stuck to the old concrete. If anyone's ever seen Joe Dirt, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
But
I was thinking
back to like my childhood and Easter.
Oh yeah.
Easter's of days gone by, basically.
Yeah.
And like Easter was never a huge holiday in our house. Like we'd have a meal or something, but we never went full blown. Like when we were kids, we'd get like Easter baskets and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember, being in school and making these colored wicker baskets.
Oh, yeah. I remember all that.
And you'd put those remember the marshmallow eggs with the hard coating?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And you used to get those.
Never liked them.
No? And you used to get those like Jujubee bunnies.
Oh, yeah.
I love the purple ones.
And you get that green stuff that is supposed to be like...
what do you call it?
I can't
think I don't even know what you call it.
But it was like supposed to be like grass or whatever.
Fake green grass. That's what I'm calling it.
Yeah.
I remember that. And those, like I said, those little jujubes, those Easter bunny-shaped jujubes.
Yeah.
I fucking love the purple ones. They tasted like spring to me, you know?
Yeah, I remember as a kid, we had an Easter meal with our family. When I was a kid, the house that I lived in is the downstairs my grandparents lived in, and we lived in the upstairs.
Right.
So we'd go down to my grandparents and have Easter dinner. It was my mom's parents. So,
okay.
And we'd have Easter dinner, and some family would come. But I can remember that my parents and even my grandparents, they would buy me chocolate, the eggs and Easter bunnies, and they'd hide them around the living room. So I had to go hunt for them.
Oh, Jesus.
They made me hunt for them. I say my dad and my dad hid them. I had to work for them, but my grandparents were kind of nice. They kind of made them kind of obvious, but still.
Yeah.
So I think they saw them all. My dad made me hunt for damn ones before. And I didn't find some. I do believe one time we found one a month later or something. It was all melted or something.
Oh, shit.
But because my dad forgot where he hid it too. But uh-huh.
Well, every year my mom would get me a crispy bunny.
Oh, crispy
bunny. You know ones with the Rice Krisps,
Yes.
I fucking love them. To this day, I love them. And I went out and got myself one a couple weeks ago. I thought, I can't let Easter go by without at least getting one of these. Because they taste identical to the Nestle Crunch Bars. Remember them?
Yeah.
I don't think you can get them here anymore. I've not seen them in years.
No, I haven't. I'm going to have to go get myself one of those bunnies
now. Yeah, they're good.
Yeah. I used to like getting the white chocolate bunnies, too.
My sister loved them. I did not care for the white chocolate. The only time I'll eat white chocolate is if it's the cookies and cream Hershey bar.
Okay.
That's the only... I don't mind. I like them. But
again, you said your sister liked them. That must have been foreshadowing.
Jeez.
Sorry.
Yeah, but...
Do you remember the Cadbury Easter eggs? Like the Cadbury eggs?
They're still around, yeah.
Yeah, but they used to be bigger.
Oh, yeah, they're tiny now.
They're tiny.
Oh, my God. They're half the size they used to be.
I remember when they were big.
Yeah. It's funny because they used to be twice the size and half the price. Now they're half the size and twice the price.
Yeah.
And but I still remember the commercials, the bunny.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the mini eggs. I love Cadbury chocolate. Period.
Oh yeah, so do I.
If I had to choose between Hershey or Nestle or Cadbury, Cadbury wins hands down.
Oh yeah,
every time.
Yeah.
Cadbury's that is the best tasting chocolate to me.
Is.
And I like the mini eggs. I love the Cadbury mini eggs too.
But, I also like the Kinder eggs.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you just want the toys. Let's be honest now.
Well, when I was a kid, yes, I liked the
toys. No, you still want them for the toys.
I haven't had a Kinder Egg in a while.
Oh, shit.
No. I heard some bigger ones.
I heard they were banned somewhere in the U.S., I think.
Yeah, they're banned in the U.S.
I heard something about that.
Canada, we still have them.
Oh, okay, yeah. I haven't had them since I was a kid either. But
then again, I'm not surprised because now we got warning labels on stuff that we never used to have warning labels.
Yeah, I know.
I saw in a car manual on that, it says, don't drink the battery. you know somebody did that. That's why they had to put that in there.
Oh, my God. Do not eat Tide Pods, No. It's funny because a couple years ago, I got a thing of honey roasted peanuts.
Yeah.
And right there, clear as day, and I had to laugh, right on the label said, warning, may contain nuts.
Yeah, I know.
Here's your sign. Yeah. Oh, my God.
And like you're saying about things that have gotten smaller and the price of it. Remember...
Aside from my penis, but that's what's... Okay. Sorry, go on.
Okay, that is too much information there, man. I do not need to know about that. But anyways, Kentucky Fried Chicken. Remember their... their salad sizes? What they call a large now used to be their medium.
Well, they're chicken themselves.
Yeah, the chickens.
They even admitted that they cut them in smaller now. They cut the breasts in half and the thighs in half, I think.
And they wonder why people are going to Popeyes.
Oh, yeah. But the thing I like about KFC is the taste.
Yes.
I love KFC's taste above all else. I'll take that over Popeyes any day.
Yeah.
Or anywhere, really, because... you know, you can't beat those 11 herbs and spices, but
And we're going to find that recipe. And I said, we're going to find that recipe.
Yeah, but I mean, they charge twice as much, and they cut the pieces in half.
Yeah.
Like half a breast is considered one piece.
Well, like I said, I remember when you used to get a large, it was like this.
Oh, yeah.
Now it's what their medium is.
Oh, yeah.
And their medium is like what their small was, and their small is, it's like a Dixie cup. Jeez. Who eats that much? That much salad, like that's like a forkful in your.
Oh, it's a lick.
Yeah, it's for the anorexic people, yeah. I guess, or I don't know, and I'm not meaning anything about that.
But it's crazy. It's like anything, like even a bag of chips, you're paying for air.
I know.
You know, I bought a bag of Ruffles, and they're kind enough to leave a few chips in the bag for me.
Yeah, you know? That's yeah. I know it's more air than chips.
That's what you're paying for. Yeah, it's fucking crazy.
Yeah, you buy the family size, you're getting a whole house full of air and maybe a few chips. Jeez. It's ridiculous. Oh, like, it's just, it's weird. It's greed.
That's what it is.
But then there is companies that are not doing that. Like I said, Popeyes is one of them, and that's because they're making money. They realize they're giving you what you want.
And I find they're a good bang for the buck. They're not overly expensive.
No, they're not. They're great.
You get a good meal from them.
Yeah.
And,
yeah. And I don't know. We still got Mary Brown's around?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we still have Mary Brown's. They got expensive, too.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
But with Mary Brown's, you're paying more for grease now than you are for chicken.
I think for a large tater and gravy there now, it's like $20.
Holy crap.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
I remember when I went to John F. Ross, when I went to the high school there, and they had a Mary Brown's across there. We used to go across at lunch and... Mm-hmm. Like, I think it was like $5 for a large and gravy.
We used to be able to get a three-piece combo for $6.49.
Yeah.
Now it's like $15. But, you know, we could go on all day long about
it. Yeah, sorry about that. I was wanting to go about the comparison of, like, how things have shrunk.
Oh, yeah.
It's crazy.
But,
yeah.
I don't know, man.
More about the Easter and when you were kids. Was there anything else you did for Easter?
Like, for Easter? We used to have a turkey every now and then, but I guess it was nothing.
Do you ever paint eggs?
No, I never did that.
I remember we did that at school.
Oh, okay. The teacher brought it in, and we had watercolor and shit. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember doing that.
I kept asking, why would you paint an egg and then you can't eat it? But
What I was going to say, too, before we start talking about chicken and whatnot, is. The cream egg McFlurries from McDonald's.
Oh, yes, yes.
I love those fucking things.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
They're not worth the size, though, because with the size of them.
They got small.
They're like $6 for a regular one. It's
well, yeah, that's why the Flurries, I know. If I'm going to get something and pay a little bit more, I go to Dairy Queen.
Oh, yeah.
And that's something. Yeah, Dairy Queen. We went to Dairy Queen on...
Yesterday.
And we were going to talk about that.
Yeah, we tried the Roadhouse burger from Wendy.
He likes
Dairy Queen.
He likes their burger.
That was good. First time I ever had a hamburger from there.
It's really good.
They are good.
If you get a chance to eat, they're great.
Oh, yeah.
It wasn't that expensive.
No.
Two of us, it was $30, but that's
see the road. Bad. See the Roadhouse burger from there is equivalent to the Smokehouse burger they call it.
Yeah,
is equivalent to the Roadhouse burger from Dairy Queen.
Yeah, you mean Burger King?
Burger King. Yeah. Oh my God, I'm losing my mind.
He's got the Royals wrong, but yeah. it's his Royal
Kings,
burger
Queens,
combo.
Jacks, Flush, Royal Flush. Jeez. I don't know. But it's equivalent to the Roadhouse King from Burger King.
Yeah.
That's what I want to say.
Yeah.
And, I really enjoyed it.
It was
a really good burger.
Think of that.
Filled me.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, fuck, I was full.
I was full, too.
Oh, my God.
But, I was going to say, I thought of this yesterday when we were there. Like, we got Burger King and Dairy Queen. I'm just waiting for somebody to make the Salad Prince or the Salad Princess or something. Burrito King or something.
Well, it's funny because downtown, when I'm on the bus heading downtown when I'm on the 10.
Yep.
When you go down Quebec Street before you turn onto Mac Donnell,
yeah,
or sorry, Wyndham, they have a place called the Tea Spot.
Yeah,
and two doors down from that is a place called the Wing Spot.
Cool.
Okay? Yeah, literally two doors down from each other. Now I've been trying to find the G Spot, but I can't seem to find that.
That's a myth to all guys.
It's a myth. Oh my God.
Women keep saying it's there, but we can't find it.
Oh, God. We're looking in the wrong place. Oh, jeez.
Well, you know, that's what...
I'm blind. That's my excuse. What's yours?
Oh, couch.
You know what they say,
why cowboys have shit in their mustache. Eh?
Looking for love in all the wrong places. Oh, my God.
We're old, sorry. That's funny. Cheech and Chong.
Oh, fuck, that's funny.
Oh, yeah.
But I heard... Did I ever play Beyonce's new song for you? The country one that she did?
Yeah, you did.
You don't like it, do you?
Yeah, I'm not a big Beyonce fan.
I like this song. It's called Texas Hold'em.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna be the first to say I'm not a big fan of Beyonce at all.
Mm-hmm.
The only other song by her I like is Single Ladies.
Oh, yeah.
But this one caught my ear, and I guess there's been a lot of controversy surrounding it because apparently the composition of this song sounds similar to the kids' TV show Franklin.
Which is a Canadian.
Yeah, Bruce Coburn wrote that song.
And I have heard somebody play the back side to side, and I can say it does sound a lot like it.
It does sound a lot like it, but it's not a carbon copy of it. Yeah. There are differences. And Bruce Coburn himself went on record saying that, no, it's not.
I know.
But I really like the song. I've been playing it a lot this week.
It's cool. It's not a bad song. I'm just not a big Beyonce fan.
Oh, no. Well, it's a different stroke.
Although I got told that because I don't like Beyonce, I'm racist.
Really?
Yeah, I had somebody tell me I'm racist. Or I don't like women. I'm a misogynist.
Oh.
Just because I don't like somebody.
See, that happened to me before Christmas because I think I told you this.
Yeah.
There was an article, I think it was on the Hollywood Reporter or Variety, one of them.
Yeah, about the rookie FBI.
Yeah, the rookie feds got canceled.
Yeah.
And I basically made, and the star of that show is a female lead, and I find this actress to be obnoxious.
Yeah.
I just something about her rubbed me the wrong way, and I reiterated that in a comment.
Yeah.
And this guy just came out, pulled no punches, said, say you're racist without saying you're a racist.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm thinking, are you fucking kidding me?
Oh, I know.
I said, you know, first of all, you do not fucking know me from a hole in the ground. So you do not know who I am or what my values are.
Yeah.
You know, I said, I just do not like the character. As far as I know, the actress could be a wonderful lady. I don't know.
Yeah.
But the character she played, she was a loudmouthed.
Yeah.
She was very obnoxious.
Yeah.
And if an actress, you know, a Caucasian actress acted the same way, I would have said the same thing.
Yeah. Well, it's some people say that about Kathy McCartney, and she's white. So
McCarthy.
Melissa McCarthy, sorry.
But I went on to say, you know, one of my all-time favorite singers is Darlene Love.
Yeah.
Who is a woman of color.
Well, yeah.
So you got to take it from where it comes.
Well, when the person said that to me, like I'm a racist or I'm a misogynist because I don't like that, I said, well, then why do I like a woman that's Aretha Franklin?
Yeah, yeah.
She was a powerful woman of color, and she was a great singer. So don't tell me just because I don't like something, I'm entitled to my thing. And I even said to the person, and you wonder why a lot of us want to go back to 1980, because at least this shit wouldn't happen in 1980. Yeah. Nobody would say that.
But I mean, in all my life, no one had ever called me a racist.
Oh, no.
You got to take it from where it comes. It's a stranger on the fucking internet.
Yeah.
And if you're going to waste your time arguing with somebody, it's not
worth it. Well, the best comeback I saw on the internet, somebody called the guy a racist. And he goes, okay, I want you to do one thing. You want to see a racist? Go look in a mirror.
Yeah.
Because it takes one to know one, doesn't it? No, that's the saying it was.
Oh, yeah.
That guy got mad about that, too.
Ah, Jesus.
Well, of course. They don't like when you turn the tables on them, too.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not trying to bring this down, but I'm sure everybody out there can relate to that.
Yeah.
There's something, if you say you... Like, nowadays, you can't have an opinion about anything.
Well, you can't, and that's why I'm starting to learn to keep my fucking mouth shut online.
Oh, yeah, I do, I do.
You know, just to... And even, like, the local city group we have called Cotton Guelph.
Yeah.
People are fucking nasty on that.
Oh, I know.
You know, if you can't have an opinion about nothing while people jumping down your throat. And you could even make the most innocent post about... Inquiring about a restaurant or something.
I know.
You're gonna have 10 fucking people on there calling you an idiot or what have
oh,
you.
Oh, I know, I know.
I've learned to just keep my fucking mouth shut on there.
But this is I call them keyboard bullies because if you were sitting face to face with them, they wouldn't be like that. Yeah.
High and mighty behind the keyboard.
And some of the but the thing is, dude, some of them might not all. They're just jumping on.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a trend.
Oh yeah, yeah.
It's like a little trend. Oh, we'll pick on these people or whatever.
Yeah.
And these groups don't like it when people are fighting back now.
Yeah. But I don't get why people can behave that way because I've always online or in person, I've always tried to treat people with respect.
Well, hey, like, going back to the Mudman show, when Sandy was talking about it, he said they got all their stuff the way they were for being friendly.
Being kind, yeah.
And being friendly.
Yeah.
Being friendly. I've always found that you be friendly. You make friends. Yeah. You know,
well, I'm friendly. I don't have a lot. I'd rather a few good friends than a shit ton of...
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
My circle's small. I like it that way.
Well, I have friends. I have close friends. And then I have a best friend.
Yeah.
But no. I got friends that I have at work.
Yeah.
And colleagues. Like, I got to say, my assistant manager... Me and her more like friends too, but anyways, what I was saying is an older person, I can, because I've seen this with some of the younger ones too,
yeah.
Is I know how to separate. If I'm at work, like say we were working at work and you're my boss,
mm-hmm.
at work, you're my boss.
Yeah, yeah.
We're not friends.
Yeah.
If we're both on break, yeah, we're friends because, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
But, and after work, we're friends. I know how to separate that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You know? But some of the young people don't know how to separate that. They think, oh, the boss is being nice to me. They're my friend and that they'll let me away with it. And when they get in trouble, they're like, well, I thought we were friends.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, we're friends, but we're at work. And guess what? You screwing up cost me my job.
There's a fine line.
Yeah. There's a fine line, and some people don't. That's why they always say you don't sometimes work with friends or family.
Yeah, exactly.
You just got to know all that. Yeah. That's the one thing. My dad's great in that, but me and him have tried to work together in that.
Mm-hmm.
It don't work.
Yeah.
It don't work.
Yeah.
Because my dad's one of those people that if you don't do it his way.
Oh, okay.
He gets mad. But like I said, it's the generation he's from.
Yeah, yeah.
You do it this way.
His way and the wrong way.
Yeah, there's the his way and the wrong way. Sometimes. Sometimes it comes to the point that, yeah, he's right, and I'm just... being pig-headed because I want to be... want to do it my way, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But it's... And when you work with your parents sometimes, we all inherit some traits from our parents.
Oh, yeah.
And both my parents were stubborn, and my grandmother used to say, worse than both of them.
I sadly inherited my father's looks. And, I'm reminded of that every day when I look in a mirror.
Oh.
That's depressing. Okay.
You're kidding, don't you?
Is it?
You're kidding, right?
No.
Oh.
No. Well, looks are the only thing I acquired from him. I'm not going to get into all that.
Oh, don't get into that. No. But it's the way people are nowadays. Like I said, I find, like you said, I treat people the way I want to be treated.
Yeah.
Do unto
others as you'd have them do unto you.
Yeah, but if they treat me like an asshole or that, I'll treat them back.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I have no problem with that, but I'm not. And, like, it doesn't matter. I've said to somebody, because somebody said, oh, you treat that person. It was at work. I had one. I'll say Indian or Arabic person, like, because he just is coloring or whatever. I'm not trying to... I couldn't tell what nationality is, but
say foreign.
Foreign, yeah. And the person, one of the people I was working with, it's one of the ones I was training. Well, you treated that person like bad. What do you don't like their kind of people? And I'm like, no, he treats me like an asshole. I treat him back like an asshole. Yeah. I treat him the way he treats me. I don't care if they're pink, purple, polka dotted, blue, whatever.
Yeah.
You can be. While invisible, I wouldn't see you. But I'm saying, you could be anything, and I'll treat you the way I want to treat.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's like I said. I got yelled at somebody that identified as a male, and it was a female that identified as male, and I called her ma'am because I don't know, you know?
Right.
Like, how are you supposed to know at the first glance, you know, like when you meet?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But anyways.
Yeah.
Other topic if you want to. I don't want to bring that in, but yeah, yeah. We were talking about how people are and stuff. And,
oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. And which, online is toxic.
Yeah.
I will say this to the one, to the any young ones out there. Be careful what you put on the internet, because even if you delete it, it lives on forever.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
They have Wayback Machines that they can find it.
Oh, yeah.
Trust me, there's some actors that got canceled because of that.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah. But anyways.
Yeah. So next week, next Saturday, we're going to check out the open mic up at the Fixed Gear.
Yep. And we'll be talking about that.
Yeah, because my buddy Donnie has been asking me to go up. Yeah. And I was going to go a couple weeks ago, but I didn't make it up there. Cause,
yeah, stuff going on.
Yeah, so going to do that. So I'm kind of looking forward to that. It'll be the first open mic I've gone to since November.
Back in November, yeah.
My God.
Yeah.
So kind of looking forward to
jamming with some people. I'm looking forward to that, too. Hopefully, we're going to hang out. And
yeah, hopefully jam with a few decent people and see where that goes. And
Maybe I'll give you your first... air fryer burger that day.
Oh, there we go. Yeah.
Over. Do that. But no, we're going to do that. And, we are going to watch a couple movies today, I hope.
Oh, hopefully.
If you're tired, we won't. But we can do it. We got time to do that.
Oh, yeah.
The holidays and that. And we're still going to record on Easter, so.
Oh, yes. Easter, yeah. We'll have our...
I'm going to bring over a ham for us to have for Easter stuff.
That'll be nice, yeah.
Going to have a little Easter dinner. Maybe I'll see if I can, that's what I'll do. I'll buy two of those bunnies and I'll bring them over too.
Oh, there we go.
I'll just get you, wait until you go to the washroom and I'll hide it around your house.
Oh, jeez.
Make the blind guy look for it.
Yeah.
I'm joking.
Well, I might find it by Christmas.
Jeez. I'll make it obvious.
Yeah, on your
door.
Yeah. How are we doing for time?
We're at 47.
Okay, we're going to wrap it up here, folks.
Yeah, because...
We're
both tired.
We're flying by the seat of our pants. The week went so fast, we didn't really have much of a chance to come up with...
But then again, last week we ran by the seat of pants, and then some people said it was our best episode.
Well, it was, yeah. But
anyways, and this is our third take.
Yeah.
That's how bad we've
been. Yeah, we're not on our game today, but whatever.
Anyways, yeah.
It is what it is.
Wrap it up.
I want to thank you guys again very much for watching.
Yep.
And hope you
ring the bell.
Ring the bell, comment, subscribe, all that fun stuff.
Yep.
We love hearing from you. We love knowing that you're out there watching this.
And we love doing this.
Yeah. So we hope you guys have a great week. We hope you have a great Easter. We'll record again Easter Sunday.
Yeah.
And it'll be up the following Tuesday. Of course, this will be up by this Tuesday.
Yeah.
And that's all I got to say.
Yeah, that's all I got too. So.
All right, you guys have a great week.
Yeah, have a good
one. And we'll catch you in the next one.
Yep.
All right, cheers.
The Kitchen Sink has been produced and edited by Andy Radke. Thanks for coming.